very warm welcome and thank you so much for watching WTV Sports Center, 14th May 2016. I do hope that you're enjoying your Saturday afternoon, a weekend full of football action, but also something else that is happening currently in France is the Kenyan national sevens team doing, of course, what they know best. You remember in Singapore, they were the best in the world, and for this time, we can only wish them the very best. Now, remember, you can always engage us online. On Twitter, you'll find us at WTVKE. Use the hashtag SportsCenter so that you're in a position to track your conversation. And let's keep the conversation alive. And now you are moving on to our first story this afternoon, and we want to focus on matters rugby. Kenya Shujaa is a household name thanks to the Kenya National Sevens team, which is currently in France. In this particular episode, we want to focus on nurturing rugby talents from the grassroots. And so we visited Upperhill Secondary School, at a school that is even going a step further to hire professional coaches to train the students. Upperhill Secondary School is known for its stellar performance in rugby and basketball. Today, we want to find out how exactly they conduct their training to emerge victorious, because as a matter of fact, in Prescott final, they faced Alliance, and as they have just told me, the best team lost, so they were runners-up. That was in rugby. So right now, as you can see, they are having their training, and we are going to talk to the instructor as well to guide us through their training schedule.
The guys come in, training starts at around 4, so by 4:10, we expect everyone to be here. We start with the small jog around the pitch. After the jog, we go through our warm-up, which involves a little bit of core work, a little bit of upper body. We cover the whole body, upper body, core, and the lower body. After the warm-up, we go to our passing drills. And then after passing drills, if there are any specific drills, we conduct that, and then we go to our patterns. Every year, we get a new team. The season that just ended, it was a winning season for us. We had a total of 4 trophies for the whole year, so in our assessment, it was a good season. There was an under-16 tournament, which we did not expect to win because it is new guys. Under-16 is usually from 1s and from 2s. So we took them there, and we came out as winners. So that was a high moment for us. And also winning the 7s metros, because ever since they started this, the devolution of the government, they came up with the counties. It divided the previous system, where it was just directly you finish with your Nairobi and then you go for nationals. But then this new system, they bought the counties, and then you had to play another round and then go for the metros, for the region, and then go and represent the region in the nationals. So ever since they started that metropolitan thing, we have never showed up. We've never been there. We show up, we get beaten in the finals. We don't go actually very far. But then this year was our first time to qualify from that. We became top, we were the final, so we represented Nairobi region. So it was a good moment for us. Sometimes people spend a lot of time working on their bodies, and then they forget about the minds. But the mind is the most important thing about a person. So the mind can tell you this, but the body can tell you differently. So we've worked on their minds, we've worked on their belief, and it worked. So working on their minds and the belief, because us knowing they could do it, it doesn't make any difference if they cannot believe it. So we have worked on their belief for them every day, you can do it, you can do it. So after they believed, it worked for them. So just their belief, their mind. This level, challenges come almost every day, because these are kids. These are kids who, they have their highs and lows frequently. So the challenges are to get this guy from class. You don't know what has happened during the day. You take this guy for like 1 hour or 2 hours a day most. The guy that you left yesterday is not the same guy who came here today. You don't know what happened to the day. You don't know what problems he's had. But then those are challenges that we experience every day. And then during the holidays, we have to dedicate some time. So for us to come back, we organize, they come back, they train, and then they go home. Some of the challenges are, some of the parents don't allow their kids to come back to school after they've left. Some, they miss the means to come, so it's a challenge for us. Sometimes we organize, we don't get the whole number, so it's a challenge. Every year we have the same targets. We always want to win. We are champions. That's what we value. We always want to win, regardless. So regardless of the guys we have, they just know our target is to win. So next season, we just want to win. We want to retain our sevens. trophy. We went to do well in our 15s. We lost the 15s in the semis, but we won the third place as a consolation. But then we want to win it. We want to win both the 15s and the 7, because it's all rugby. At this level, there's no major difference between 7 and 15. It's all rugby. So we want to win both of them this coming season. Younger guys just have to believe in themselves, because people tell you a lot of things. People tell you you cannot do it. People tell you, they see you, they're like, they ask you where you're from in the pitch playing rugby. They ask you how. You cannot make it. So that's the challenge these kids go through. So for our to them, they just should believe. If there's no one to believe in them, if they believe in themselves, that is everything. They just have to believe in themselves. They just have to work hard, be consistent in whatever. In rugby, in life anyway, you just have to work hard, be consistent. So being with them, I know these kids. I know if they want to do it, they can do it. I handle them up to this level. After that, it's all about them. We try very hard to mentor them after, to ask them how they are, to, you know, show them the way. But then after, it's all up to them, because after you leave school, things happen. You get this, you get that, school comes in, you know, plans come in. So, but then guys who want, they can do it. We have some few guys who finished the year. I think they do well in the national team. They can make the national team. Some were chosen for the under 18, for the games, but I don't know if the games are still on. So if they're still on, the guy will do well. They have introduced levels of rugby, and I see those guys train very well. I go to the training to see the guys. I see some of my previous guys. They do very well. They go for exposure trips. And then some of them even feature in the national team. So that means it's going somewhere. You just don't train and then. So I just will urge them to continue. You know, they don't start something and then you leave it halfway. Or you don't nurse it, or you don't see how it's going. So they've introduced it, now they have to keep feeding it, you know, feeding it to grow until there's a point where it can handle itself. So they don't leave it there. The development is good, but then they should not leave it there. Also, they should concentrate on the school's level, because they are very nice players, very good players who, if they are developed further, they can make very good players. So they should also look at this level, support the players, develop them, because some of these guys don't know where to go next.
I attend every training session that these guys normally have so that I can see where I can correct, where I can tell them, like, it's not done this way, it's not it's done this way, where I can, like, help them, like, know what's the importance of doing such a thing. And then also I'm trying to, like, find a person who can replace me in terms of being the captain. And currently I can say that it's faring on well. Well, there are different aspects in whoever I look up to, because, like, in terms of speed, I look up to Colin Sinjera. In terms of power, I also look up to Colin Sinjera. So most of the time I can say that, like, Colin Sinjera is my mentor. I am impressed with their performance, because you see, like, every Kenyan was like, these guys cannot make it, these guys are going to be relegated. But personally, I felt like, although there are so many issues coming up with the rugby union, I felt like they really outdid themselves, and their performance was very good. I see myself playing in Super Rugby, because I've had so many opportunities where guys call me to, like, come for trials, to, like, shoot a video so that they can send to people. And in 10 years' time, I see myself in the playing for Super Rugby and also for the Kenya team.
As a mentor, mostly because I'm a defensive guy, I normally believe in the defense. So Billy Odhiambo, normally known as the Billy the Kid, because mostly knows how to mark the outside winger. And that's the most delicate part in the seventh game. The winger has to be perfect in also timing his tackles, and also in terms of maybe brains, also look up on our scrum off a game. Yeah, I like them to continue playing hard mentally, and also have the courage and also heart to drive forward, and also have the brains to see what is in front of them. And they don't forget that it was the skill that kept them there. So they should also work on it, tap to their fullest potential, and go and reach the main cup. When I clear campus, I want to be an aeronautical engineer. Also, I'd like maybe even also to continue with my rugby, and maybe even play for a Kenya team and even internationally to clubs where I maybe like to play. I chose rugby because it kind of gave me a passion for it, and mostly What drives me to the game is my passion to it, not even my size or even what I do else, but my passion. That's how I get to commit or make the job done.
Oh, wow! That has been your weekly feature of Emerging Stars, and we've just been talking to the captain, and he has just reminded me of one thing. Never judge a book by its cover. Small-bodied, but he leads a great team that goes to greater heights. That has been your weekly feature, Emerging Stars. Sports Center continues. Well done, Upperhill Secondary School. How I wish other secondary schools across the country can embrace that, investing in the students. And now we come to the end of our part one, but keep it WTV, because when we come back, we have a lot lined up for you, and we'll be talking to one man, that is Raymond Klanderman, who has all the latest from the English Premier League. Stay tuned.
The moment that Leicester has been waiting for. Finally, they get their hands on the trophy. The first new winners of the English top division since Nottingham Forest back in 1978.